My name is Alfredo Ornelas. I am a third-year doctoral student in the chemistry department at the University of Texas at El Paso. I am currently doing research in Dr. Michael's lab.
Hi, I'm Caitlin Williams, and I'm a senior undergraduate at the University of Texas El Paso. My major is forensic chemistry, and I am also working in Dr. Michael's lab.
We are currently working in an interdisciplinary research project with two professors in physics and bioengineering at the University of Texas at El Paso. The overall idea of the project is to develop a novel collagen-like peptide that has special photochemical properties that will be used to carve out microtunnels. These microtunnels are going to be used to mimic a three-dimensional microvascular system where cells can grow and receive enough nutrients and oxygen. These microtunnels are going to be carved out using a very special photochemical process called two-photon absorption using a femtosecond laser. We have achieved our first milestone in the project, which is the synthesis of the photoreactive collagen-like peptide. This peptide consists of several photoreactive nitroendolin moieties, which are actually not commercially available. So the first step in this project was to synthesize this nitroendolin moiety. When Caitlin joined our lab, her first task was to synthesize this photosensitive group. I taught her the basic techniques to perform research in an organic chemistry lab. And can you tell me, Caitlin, what have you learned during the synthesis?
So first coming into the lab, I had no idea how an organic chemistry lab worked. And given this task of the seven-step synthesis and your excellent help, I was able to set up reactions, monitor them by TLC. And as you can see here, this is a reaction, actually the last reaction of the seven-step process, which is the palladium-catalyzed dealylation. After the reaction is finished, the product is then purified through column chromatography, which Alfredo did excellently teach me as well. And then after purification, it is characterized by proton NMR and carbon-13 NMR spectroscopy.
In order to synthesize this peptide, I came up with the idea to synthesize two different peptides, one being a photoreactive hexamer and the other one being a solid-supported peptide. After several peptide fragment condensations, we were able to obtain a photoreactive collagen mimicking peptide. I taught Caitlin how to perform solid phase peptide synthesis and the purification of the peptides.
After cleaving the peptide, we purified it through size exclusion chromatography, and then we purified it through reverse phase fast protein liquid chromatography. We had to test to see if our peptide was actually photoreactive. So we dissolved our peptide in water, irradiated it with UV light, and it was confirmed through mass spectrometry that our peptide did cleave into the segments that we needed them to be.
If we want to perform this photochemistry that requires UV light, specifically 350 nanometers, through a two-photon absorption, then we can use two photons of 700 nanometers, and when their energy add, we can trigger this for reaction. So far, by studies performed by our collaborators in physics, we have good indications that our photoreactive collagen mimicking peptide is indeed undergoing two-photon absorption.
So how do you know it's two-photon absorption and not one-photon absorption?
After we received the results from our collaborators in physics, where they performed an experiment with our photoreactive collagen mimicking peptide using a femtosecond laser, we obtained this graph where we plot the decay constant over the intensity of the laser. First of all, what we can see is that as the intensity of the laser increases, the decay constant, which is proportional to the rate constant, it's increasing, which makes sense. And good indicative that we actually have a two-photon absorption is that when you plot the log of beta, which is the decay constant, and it's directly proportional to the log of the intensity squared, then we should see that the slope of the graph should be 2. And what we have in our graph is that our slope is actually very close to 2. If you have a 1-photon absorption, then the slope would be closer to 1. So this is a pretty good indicative that our photoreactive collagen mimicking peptide is undergoing photolysis through a 2-photon absorption process. So after all these results, what conclusions do you have so far, Caitlin?
So in conclusion, we successfully synthesized our photoreactive collagen mimicking peptide and have good indicative that it is undergoing two-photon absorption. So with these promising results, we are able to make material that could potentially be used for tissue engineering in the future.